All right, hello everybody. It is I, Granorite. Here we are back with another episode of Let's Play Pokémon Crystal with our Gen Crystal, Pokémon Emerald. I'm gonna be stuck on. You know, you do this for 2 years, you get a little stuck. We're on Pokémon Emerald, and we're here doing our Rock type playthrough. We're gonna go into the seventh gym. So here we go. Yeah, Pokemon Crystal. Thank you, Crescentabon. How are you doing today? What's this do? Oh. Interesting. So that's how we can get, you know, not only the statues moved around, but some double battles going. So that's nice. That's neat. So you playing the best mini game in Assassin's Creed, Checkers, or the other smaller board one? Calm Mind is pretty legit. The Checkers looking one. I mean, it was just Checkers. That game in Assassin's Creed 3 took you a while to beat it and get the achievement. We just have like those little challenges, so there's still one more game we need to find. I think it's Liar's Dice, and win, and then we just need to get enough money, which we'll probably just get the money playing Checkers, because I mean, you can just play Checkers. This is quite the setup in here. Let's go with this one next. I'm not sure where these warp tiles go. We're just gonna have to find out. I don't want to go anywhere. What we got here? Let's take out the Kadabra. Right, I still want to take out the Kadabra. Shuckle can use Rollout on Draft Ring. Oh, it's so fast. Yeah, it's probably gonna deal some good damage. Onix doesn't have special defense. Swap these two. Can I get both of them? Looks like I can. Oh no, I can't. I didn't work. job of that. Steven chooses correctly. Which it's not. But I think we had enough damage to the rock slide, we could take it out with a rock slide. Alright, this takes us up here. We can't do anything here. Splink. What a combo. Darn that Splink. Splink. But then gave Nosepass a berry that cures confusion, I guess. Splink avoided the attack. Wow, Splink is just so powerful. So does that protect itself from... I don't even know what magic code does. No idea. Krishnabon, do you know what magic code does? Looks like I can get them to move by hitting this. But it didn't save it, so it wasn't good then. Yes. Accurate. Let's take a look. Where's my phone? It's in my pocket. Let's nuke this meta type. Magic code reflects back to the target moves like Leech Seed. Moves like Leech Seed and moves that damage status. Good to know. So we're moving this so we can get up to this other warp over here. Oh, I see. See what I need to do. Still can't. Okay, so we can't do anything there. Okay. do Shuckle Regirock. I think. What do these two have? Then we should just have the gym leaders. Good deal. Let's just hyper beam it. Pull out the big guns. Alright, we're gonna go heal really quick since we're right here by the entrance. Get everybody back up to full. Alright, let's give Nosepass another. I don't have another move? I do, okay. And I'm thinking we're gonna go with Regirock Nosepass up front. So how many episodes is each Gen 3 playthrough gonna take? I don't know. What are we on, 14 now? Could take close to 20. I mean, because I'm trying to think, we still have to get through the 8th gym leader. We still have more plot stuff to do. Yeah. And we have the Elite Four, and then we have a little bit of in-game stuff, and then, like, Steven? Like, I mean, we're just gonna have to see. Have another fun team. Oh boy. Alright, we made it to the two of them. I hope we're ready. I think it's about as good as we're gonna get here on this team. And it's a double battle gym battle. Quaidol and Zatu starting out. They are psychic type. Claydol is probably going to be dangerous. But I think we want to Ancient Power down Zaw too. And then what is Rock Slide? Confuse Rays. Okay, well, Confuse Rays knows Pass. He's got a Prism Berry, so we got lucky there. See, now that's what I'm worried about is the Earthquake. But both of these Pokemon have pretty good defense. Especially Regirock. Maybe not so much Nosepass. That really hurt. Soul Rock, okay. We try to take out Play Doll here. Uses another earthquake.
So Nosepass is gonna go down.
Let's send out we don't want to send out Magcargo until after this Clay Doll is gone. Oh, is it a Solar Beam? Oh my goodness. That's dangerous. And our Hyper Beam missed. And even Onix with all its defense can't take that earthquake well. Here comes the Solar Beam. There goes Lodestone. Alright, we got the Clay Doll down. That's what matters. Alright, let's get rid of this Soul Rock. Oh, now it also knows Sunny Day to make the Solar Beams come more quicker. Isn't that something? And it uses Psychic in the sun. Okay. Alright, we got Toxic on both of them. What, a citrus berry? At least they've identified correctly that Regirock is the danger here. That's three Pokemon down. Everything is gonna be all right. How you can't hurt Shuckle? It's impossible. You should push a bit below. Soul Rock should go down to the Toxic. It's a bad time to miss Shuckle. All mean, if you look, like, it's only doing, like, 20-something damage to Shuckle with a Psychic. Excellent. You Hyper Potion away. Magcargo's got two amnesias on. Yeah, it's not taking a whole lot of damage from that either. But this just goes to show how more difficult Gen 3 is going to be than what Gen 2 ever was. Heal up. All right. Swap up a lodestone. Give ourselves a badge. We earned that. And our next gem, the 8th gem, is water type. Ooh boy. Some rocks at the Zubat. Get out of here. Poochyena. We'll just keep Onix up for Poochyena. At least we got the level up on Shuckle. That's nice. Focus energy. Bam. Our berry. Awakens. We'll give this to Nosepass. So what'd you think of that gym fight, Krishnabon? part of the reason that I was like, should we do EV training? And we're like, nah, we're just gonna train regularly. Oh, it knows levitate. Oh, okay. Outrageous building! Mighty Yenna. Okay. The bite's gonna do good damage because, you know, Onix just doesn't have special defense. Good job hitting those rock throws, even with two sand attacks, though. We'll swap for the Numble. Let's go to Magcargo. Job. Alright, we'll go to Regirock here for this other Mighty Yenna. No double battles? You just only have 1, 2, 3? Really? I meant to use rock throw without range. Oh well. Come on, Onix. Nice. That Mighty Yenna brought that on itself. Sandstorm's fine. Now we're gonna swap Regirock. Talk to Maxi. Oh, I only gotta choose three, okay. Since we're pairing with someone. He's got his Metang. He's gonna start out with. We both have clear body, that's funny. Swagger. Swagger on the Regirock was a good choice. Not good. Withdrew the Mighty Anna and sent out another Camel Rupt. The two attack boosts that we got from the Mighty Anna, well, I guess it's just one. No, it was two, because we didn't get hit by the, Intimidate. That's gonna hurt. It's gonna hurt Regirock. Still confused though. That blows. We're gonna lose both our Pokemon to another earthquake here. Oh, Metang hangs on though. Let's do Shuckle. Oh, Aggron. Good choice. Now we just have one slot that we're dealing with because we've already dealt with the other one. Sunlight's gonna use Solar Beam, really? Interesting choice. Well, who am I to argue? It did the trick, didn't it? Another Intimidate drop here from the Mighty Inna. Actually works this time. Does a tier 3 roll out? Okay, taunts the Aggron. Who's gonna use Solar Beam again? Tier 4. Swaggers the Aggron. It would have been so good if you would have hit it, because then you could have used this tier 5 on the next one, but oh well. Cannot poison a Crobat. Aggron snapped out of its confusion and uses Thunder. Well, that's an attack. Shuckle missed. Come on. Making me look bad next to Steven. So heal again. Regirock went down that last fight. Probably need to go to Steven's house next, which is where? Here. Good choice. Teach dive. So we need waterfall for the end game, and we want it on this Mew, but what we can do is we can teach dive right now and then go to the move deleter and get rid of dive and then replace it with waterfall. Alright, we're gonna go up here first. Here. throw some rocks at that Weagle. Excellent. Swap the Regirock for this Machoke. Can we take it out with a single Hyper Beam? We sure can. Swap up Nosepass. Still gonna put Shuckle back up here. After we take a bubble beam, it's gonna hurt. It's gonna really hurt. Well, it's a critical hit. Good paralysis. Oh, hung on, really? I see we were okay if it wasn't a critical hit. Keep Thunderbolt. Couple twins up here. Wobbling and Numor. Okay. Good deal. All right, well, she saw Rayquaza. What do you have? Seeking. Okay. Misses the Supersonic, so that's good. So we're up here just fighting trainers to get more experience. Roast that fish. Thank you. Oh, I woke up? Really? Come on. So apart from all the other stuff we have to do, our next target for the final gym is level 46. And he's got a Kingdra. What you got? Love Disc. Forget that Pokemon even exists. Tracker to update when I went in the switch. We have a Nosepass on our team. Just not showing. Alright, we need Lodestone and Magcargo for this next fight. Drop a sandstorms first. Good damage, Magcargo. And it roars away my Magcargo and brings out Nosepass, okay. Good chance Nosepass goes down. Roar, that's right. Hey, what did you think of that last gym leader fight for Shinnabon? Well, Zatu avoided the attack. That's why I actually wanted to hit with it. Roars away the Nosepass and brings out... Okay, well, Mew's just going to get knocked out. Yeah, the psychic one. Tough fight, and it could have been bad if you used Solar Beam instead of psychic during a sunny day. Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. You gonna knock out my Mew? No, they're not. All right, there goes Mew. Thank you. Yeah, no, it was tough. It was a tough fight. And like I said, like, that's kind of like what shows why, like, I was kind of like, oh, do we need an Eevee train? Because this game is tough. Like, these games get a lot tougher. See if that's the Gen 3 Whitney fight. I think it's really going to depend on the type that we're doing. Like, I think there's going to be certain teams that are going to walk through that psychic gym. I really do. There's also going to be... Like, I think we're really going to struggle at the 8th gym here, even if we're at the same level. it was just swap. We have one more trainer on this route. Should be a swimmer, a male swimmer, here he is. With a single horsey. Yeah, the 8th gym is water. It's gonna be a test to see if we can even take on the champion, who's water. Times a battle could be bad if they use the correct moves, but they do dump. Yeah, and it all really depends on if we have time to set up. That is correct. Alright, we need to go south of here. Everybody is at the next level. Item here. I don't think we can really use our vitamins anymore when we get them. What's the level of the team will be? So I've been looking at that because, you know, that is a very valid question, and I've been trying to see what we want to get them up to. The Elite Four's highest level Pokemon is level 58. Due to the difficulty that we're going to have with the monotype on some teams, and the fact that I want to try to have let the team be fully evolved by the time we would take on the Elite Four, I think we're going to get, no matter the team, I think we're going to get the team up to level 55 before we go into the Elite Four. And then for Steven, his highest level Pokemon is 78. I think they're all in the 70s there. I think we can try it at level 70. And if we don't get it then we can level up more if need be. Candy here. We're gonna go back and heal. It It's just Onix isn't good. We got paralyzed. You know, the fact that Onix can get paralyzed by static still makes me upset. So there should be a bunch of fishermen along here somewhere. We're gonna just check for trainers. So we have three fishermen, a triathlete, a black belt. There should be six more trainers. I mean, yeah, exactly. That's my opinion. I don't know who this is. I'm on my list here. Ah, okay. Even static, yeah. I mean, that's my opinion. Just means that when we do electric playthroughs, we're gonna be really have an advantage with Pokemon knowing static. You know, there's like several of those. This one, like Effect Spore on grass Pokemon, has a chance to do like any random status effect. Poison Point on certain Pokemon. Sharpedo, okay. Is there a gym in this gen that would be like Whitney for most teams? I don't know. I mean, that's a good question. I don't think I have an answer for that. Maybe Norman's gym with that slacking, but no, there's nothing that comes immediately to mind. Magikarp. Yeah, there's nothing that comes immediately to mind that I'm like, that one's gonna be a problem all the time, no matter what. we're gonna finish out this route. And then we'll call this episode. So we have a few more trainers. After this one, we have two more trainers we can get. Was not the right choice. Bubblebee was the right choice. Okay, we're gonna do a Dragon-type playthrough next with Rayquaza. You've decided. Can do. We'll have a good team next time, yeah. Sounds good to me. I think we needed that stat boost, Regirock, but okay. Alright, we have one more trainer on here we can take on. See if the lodestone can take it out. Yes, it'll be a team of four, you are correct. Alright, but we are going to end this episode here. We do hope you all enjoyed, and we'll see you next time. Thank you, everybody.